From the capital city, you're watching This Week in Iowa with Sabrina Ahmed, getting to the heart of what's happening in Iowa politics.
And I've received a lot of positive encouragement and prayers to support life and not to stop a beating heart. This is about life, and this is, you know, I believe that life is life, whether it's inside the womb or outside of the womb.
And with the stroke of a pen, Iowa has one of the most restrictive abortion bans on the books in the country. That was sound from Governor Kim Reynolds after she signed what's called the Fetal Heartbeat Bill in May, banning abortions after a heartbeat is detected, which can be as early as 6 weeks into pregnancy. The ban is currently held up in the court system, so it's not being enforced right now. But the issue of women's reproductive rights and protecting life remains a top issue on Iowa's voters' minds, especially as we are 5 months after that bill was signed, but only 2 days on Sunday away from the election. So joining me now to talk about the impacts of these issues on Iowa's elections is Bob Vander Plaats, who is the head of the Iowa Family Leader, a conservative group here in Iowa. Bob, nice to see you. Thank you for being here.
Good to see you. Thanks for having me.
The moment that Governor Kim Reynolds signed that fetal heartbeat bill was a big victory for your group. How have conservatives been using that in this election?
Well, it was a big victory. Matter of fact, we cheered Governor Reynolds on a lot, as we knew she was a pro-life governor, and she meant it. She wasn't doing it for political gain. She wasn't doing it because this is going to help her win the 2018 election. She was doing it because it was the right thing to do. She's a true believer in the sanctity of human life, as are we. And as she said in that video clip that preceded our segment here, if a beating heart signifies when someone dies because it stops, then a beating heart should also say that's when life, there's life there. And so we were thrilled to see her sign the heartbeat bill. It has completely energized our base. And we're very optimistic that she will go over the finish line and be reelected as Iowa's governor.
Some political ads that we've seen attack Iowa Republican lawmakers because they supported this piece of legislation during the legislative session. So how do you address those attack ads?
Well, I just find it really ironic for them to say this is such an extreme position. Extreme is what I believe is Fred Hubbell's position. You know, abortion on demand all the way up till the baby is born, selling the fetal body parts once the baby has been aborted. That's an extreme position. So if I'm Kim Reynolds or if I'm one of the other legislative candidates, I would much rather argue a culture of life, which I believe Iowans support, versus a culture of death. And that's why when you see somebody be abducted or whatever else, Iowans go out like crazy because they want to protect that life. Iowans are about a culture of life, not about a culture of death. And I think you'll see that happen on November 6th.
One big concern or big question mark for both the Republican and the Democratic Party is women who are college educated living in those suburban areas. Traditionally, they voted Republican, but that could change this year. And part of that is because of this bill. So what are you doing to rally those women voters to vote Republican?
Well, I think those women voters, frankly, if they don't vote for Kim Reynolds, they're missing a great opportunity. I think some of that is a ripple effect of Donald Trump. That's why some of them are going away, maybe from a Republican ticket. Mm-hmm. But with Governor Reynolds, what they're seeing is someone who not only champions a culture of life with the sanctity of human life, but she prides herself on being an educational governor, how to serve people with special needs. But it's about creating jobs and opportunities. I think those suburban women are going to see they have a champion in Kim Reynolds, not just from the culture of life when it comes to the abortion issue, but the culture of life when it comes down to economic issues, education issues, and how you serve the most vulnerable in our state.
If Republicans maintain control of the state house, all three, both the, of course, the House, the Senate, and the governor's office, after the midterm election, what does that mean for the family leader's goals? How do those shift? How do those go further?
Well, first of all, we believe that if all three branches are under, say, conservative leadership, we think that's really good for pro-family, whether it be tax policy, life policies, all types of policies that we think would benefit Iowa. Matter of fact, when you take a look at it, right now, Iowa has never done better when it comes to the job market, when it comes to unemployment rate, when it comes to household incomes, all those things. Iowa is going in the right direction. This would be like the New England Patriots saying, we've won so many Super Bowls, let's take Tom Brady out as quarterback. You wouldn't do that. Nor do I think Iowa should take Kim Reynolds out as governor at this point as well.
Do you think that we will see more conservative bills like this, like the fetal heartbeat bill, moving forward if Republicans maintain control?
Well, I think what you'll do is you'll see, if Republicans maintain control, you'll see more policies that are enacted or advocated for that champion the sanctity of human life, that champions the sanctity of marriage and family, that champions pro-economic policy, that champions, you know, the individual versus the government. I think those are all good things for the state of Iowa.
We mentioned that fetal heartbeat bill is tied up in the courts right now. What are the next steps for the right to life movement if that is deemed unconstitutional by the Iowa Supreme Court?
Well, first of all, I think you have to take a look at the courts as a whole. 2010, Iowans voted out 3 Supreme Court judges because they outstepped their constitutional bounds when it came to marriage. If this court determines that there's a constitutional guarantee to abortion in the Iowa Constitution, that is just completely absurd. I think we need to take a look at the courts, how we nominate judges to the courts, and then the people of Iowa still have that check in the retention box to say, do we want to keep that justice or not keep that justice?
If it's deemed unconstitutional, will you lead the fight to remove some of the justices from the bench?
I don't know if I will lead the fight, but I'll definitely participate in the conversation in regards to what is constitutional, what is unconstitutional, what is judicial overreach, what is tyranny at a very level. And if that happens to be the case, I'm sure I'll be part of the discussion.
Bob Vander Plaats, thank you so much. I appreciate your time.
Thank you, Sabrina.
We'll take a short break and we'll be right back.